Tell you what's interesting, David, is Tesla up, but this Nikola, which I know that has been a kind of a convoluted situation. Well, Hindenburg, which of course is a, you know, an allusion to a tremendously unsuccessful Zeppelin, is saying that while Trevor Milton, founder Trevor Milton's departure may give the appearance of a company that's moving on, we believe this is only the beginning of Nikola's unraveling. Nikola's almost no intellectual property, products, or revenue to fall back on. We think the company's key asset was its founder's ability to raise money through hype. And then I know this is, I'm going to caveat this. The Hindenburg is saying outright lies. I think that that is libel. It's got to be careful. General Motors, he says, should carefully evaluate the potential long-term damage to its 112-year brand by continuing to tie itself to Nikola. David, this is one of those that it's down a lot, but it's not over.
All right. Well, we're going to discuss it a lot more, Carl, but let's get the opening bell.
Guys, there's the opening bell. As we said, breath looks to be pretty weak here. We'll watch some of the early movers. Jim and David mentioned Nikola, and we did get a statement out of GM today saying they're going to work to close that transaction. I see Citron. Phil LeBeau says, as soon as you talk about suing the shorts, you've played your hand.
Yeah, and you heard Jim read the statement from Hindenburg Research. The shorts look at this, and they look at shares of Nikola that pre-market, they were down, 22%? They were down trading at, down 28%, now trading under $25 a share. You're going back to the levels that we saw in May. And remember, it was right before the SPAC IPO, the reverse merger with Invecto Q came out, and then boom, they took off. And a lot of that was fueled, the oxygen, if you will, for Nikola. It came from Trevor Milton. It came from him saying, this is what we're doing with the Badger electric truck. We're going to have Nikola world. We're going to have hydrogen fuel cell semis. We are going to revolutionize transportation. He truly was the face of this company. And even though he was not the CEO of this company, he spoke as if I'm running this company. Mark Russell is still the CEO of Nikola. But remember, after they had their quarterly results and they came out and they said, this is what's happening. And during the conference call, Mark Russell answered a number of questions. Well, the street didn't react with, you know, any great reaction there. They were like, well, you know, what's the future for these guys? Who was on air? Who was on social media within 24, 48 hours? It was Trevor Milton. So he has been the oxygen that has kept this stock anywhere between $35 and $55 a share. And now he is gone out of this company. He's a consultant till the end of the year, but he's not the executive chairman anymore. He's not on the board of directors. And if he even wants to tweet, which has long been his platform, or Instagram, if he even wants to say anything about Nikola, it's got to be cleared by Nikola's legal counsel.
Well, Phil, let me just ask you, you know, there still is, I mean, GM is making things for them. I mean, that's not...
Yes,
I mean,
they will be.
I know
the
GM, you can say that they got tied in with someone bad, but GM's got to doing something. It's good for GM, right?
I think GM's perspective on this is, look, we got an 11% stake in this company that will be paying us to build their electric pickup truck, the Badger electric pickup truck, and that's going to be built at, they haven't announced this yet, but most likely at the Hamtramck plant in Detroit, which adds size and scale, which is what they want for their EV platform, for the Ultium battery platform. They want size and scale. They just don't want to have GM vehicles. They're going to be working with a number of automakers. And the hydrotech element of this, where they're going to be making hydrogen fuel cells that will be used by Nikola in the hydrogen fuel cell semis that they're developing in Europe, that's what GM will be supplying as well. So I think GM looks at this, and by the way, they are committed to staying in this relationship with Nikola. They look at this as there's upside here. What downside is there? If Nikola were to fall apart completely, what's the downside to General Motors? Okay, you don't build the Badger pickup truck. It's embarrassing maybe that this was not a deal that went through. But otherwise, there's not a whole lot of downside here.